Okay, hopefully you can hear me. It is a nice downpour here as we're driving in Toronto. And if you look carefully, I've got the autopilot set at 70 in a 60 zone. But this is the message that's coming up because of the rain, I guess, and the vision only. And now it went away, and now it's come back. That's what I can see on my screen. That's the speed I'm going at. Now we're coming up to a red light. But that comes on every now and then as the rain picks up and goes away. And then we slow down. I guess when you speed up too, the rain is more prominent on the windshield, so then it comes up. And that's one limitation, I guess, of the Tesla Vision, using the camera-based or the camera-only-based technology. I don't know if radar would be affected with the rain like this, heavy torrential downpours. I suspect not. I've never had that message come up on my Model 3 when I had it, so I suspect that, like I said, comparing radar to camera only, this may be a camera only issue or limitation, I guess you could say. Let's see what happens as we start going out, lights green. The rain's coming down just as much as it was before. Let me see what happens when we get up to speed. Because it seemed to have done it after I hit 50 kilometers. So we're coming up to 50. No, 50 had nothing to do with it. I think it was just a concentration of rain on the windshield. So let me know down in the comments below if you guys have experienced this before with your radar cars or with your camera only cars. I'm curious if you've had a torrential downpour like this where it affected the autopilot speed. I mean, we've got some good rain here in the last few minutes. Like, as you can see, the cars in front of me are going over and just splashing up water. There's a lot of standing water on the roads. Okay, now that we're even on the highway, we're still getting the message, as you can see down here. That's the message we're getting. And it's not raining as heavy, but we're going faster, so we're getting more water on the windshield from the rain. So maybe that's why it's coming on. And it's limiting me down to like low 70s. That's probably too slow. There's other cars passing me. I like to slow down in the rain, but I don't want to do 70 on the highway. When I say 70, I mean kilometers, which, you know, that's not even 50. That's like 45 miles. So it's good that it's slowing down for poor visibility, but don't slow down too much, because then you make it even more of a safety issue. And just so you know, not just autopilot with lane keeping assist and everything, just TAC control, the traffic aware cruise control, it limits the speed for that too, because I'm not in full autopilot. I'm just in traffic aware cruise control, and it's limiting my speed, as you can see, to 70, like the mid 70s. I have it set to 110, and the car in front of me is speeding away from me slowly, but it is limiting me. Now it's gone away. Now it's picked back up to about 80. But see, now it comes back. It comes and goes, it flashes. I guess the system's constantly reading the visibility from the cameras. So anyways, just a short video, wanted to show you guys that. Let me know in comments below. Thanks for watching. See you later, guys.